Secondly,
just put off
this our man.
Yeah,
he's come swaggering back in from Bali, he's not happy with a piece of the landscape.
Well, I'll tell you what happened, boys. I've obviously, as you know, I was away last week. So on the plane back, midnight flight, I've got a 2.5-year-old. I get her to bed, I get her to sleep on the plane, and I start writing my article. Well, I'm 3/4 of the way through it. I was writing it from the pool to start with, and then it sort of extended onto the plane. So I'm sort of finishing it off, and I'm thinking, wow, and I'm keeping my eye on the media, and I'm thinking, okay, so this is all good. No one's really written this. People have spoken about it, everything else.
This sounds like someone else who used to sit in that chair about their articles, they write.
But this fascination started long, long, long ago. And I'm talking way before this man.
Is someone copying
his name, the duck? His name's Matthew Lloyd.
Hello.
Right? Come on, Velvet.
No. So many years ago, when I'm walking out of a sort of a club, many years ago, this car pulls up. I'm waiting for a taxi. Just standing there, sort
of it's got some roots.
Just kicking a can down the road. It's sort of not a great night.
And, unusual.
I'm waiting for a taxi, and this car pulls up full of young gentlemen driving, so not drinking, very sensible, but it was probably 1 in the morning.
Yes.
And they pull up, they say,
wonder what they were doing.
And they go, hey, Duck, King, you know, we'll give you a drive. Where do you live? And I said, well, at the time I was living at Keilor. I said, oh, boys, I live out at Keilor. You're prepared to drive me out there? And that's where these gentlemen were from. They were from out that way. They said, jump in. We'll, you know, give us a lift. So I get in the back, and anyway, they drop me off, and, you know, they're trying to sort of talk footy and conversation. I wasn't giving them a lot. And then as I'm getting out, one of the young gentlemen says, hey, you know who this guy in the back seat is? And I said, well, no. And they said, this is Matthew Lloyd, and he's going to be a star. He's going to be. And I went, yeah, good on you, mate. Anyway, so I get out.
Which he was, by the way.
Go into the house. No, he hadn't been drafted or done anything.
Talking
in this
to the king here.
So I'm six guys who kicked more goals in this game.
So I go into the, I go home, and then I don't hear of this young man for a few years. Then all of a sudden he hits the scene at Essendon, and guess what? He asked for the number 18.
Duck.
So all of a sudden, Lloyd.
Hey, hang on.
Come on, Duck.
He didn't ask for the 18 because of that meeting.
Well,
surely.
Now it's sort of built. This sort of a story's building and building and building. I'm thinking, okay, well, that's fair enough.
He builds soon.
He obviously idolised me. So he's gone and got the number 18.
Where are you going with this?
An absolute champion of the game. Where I'm going with it is not only that. So I get off the plane and then.
Back to the present.
So then yesterday, I'd sort of pick up The Age and I look at my article and I go, that's...
Were you in the sun too
That's
long?
Fantastic. The Age probably. I made the front and the back page of The Age and, because I basically said Damien Hardwick...
They're almost the same thing.
Most things do these days.
So Damien...
Not a lot in between, JB. And by the way, it's lucky to make the street.
Yes.
So I get to the footy last night, and then something bobs up on my Twitter feed, and Matthew Lloyd, and clearly there's a bit of a fascination. So Matthew Lloyd has written pretty much an identical...
You're saying he copied you?
An identical article that is in today's paper for the Herald Sun.
Hang on.
It is almost carbon copy of that. And to top it off...
But he would have written it way
What's
before.
It about?
And to top it off, it's about Damien Hardwick being... We both think that he's right now the coach of the year, and the way he's turned the footy club around, blah blah blah. But it's basically word for word.
Two guys can have the same opinion.
So then I'm driving into the ground today, and I'm not happy. So I'm driving down.
Not happy about Lloydie.
Well, I'm not happy that he's copied my article, and I'm driving.
How could he have copied it if they're both released at the same time?
They're not, because mine went in yesterday. His has gone in today.
Yes, but he wrote his the other day.
No, how do you know that?
Anyway, as if Lloydie would base his article on what you've written.
Well, of course he would, because he's boring.
Duck, please.
And
no, he's not. The last thing he'd do is that.
So then I'm driving down Toorak Road this morning. Now, you know, there's a lot of cafes and hairdressers and everything else. There I am. I sort of walk past, and there's Lloydie getting a haircut.
Oh,
and he's asked the hairdresser to cut a hole in the top of his head.
No!
Just so he's like me.
Oh, no.
Can you believe it?
Well, not only is it about the same story.
Oh, Duck wants it. The top of his head.
I get the feeling that Duck is liking that story far too much.
Look at him.
It isn't actually that, for the funny.
Oh, crumb. I wondered where it was going.
Boy,
all in fun, Lloydy. No, he would have, you're right.
More
he would have
to do about the duck than it did Lloydy.
A lot more.
Well, let's hope he, yeah.
He might have made the point a bit better than you do.
Let's hope he doesn't copy. He had a good chance to read it and then maybe change it.
I think he pre-writes them a few days before and submits, so there's been a bit of a mess up there. Yeah. But okay. I think it's, you know, you're both on the track, so well done.
You wouldn't have read either article,
Peter. Couldn't give a stuff.